Hi, my name is Lauren Byrne, and I'm a research fellow at UCL Huntington's Disease Centre. My research career in Huntington's disease began in 2014, but in reality, I've been researching Huntington's disease for the most part of my life. I grew up in a family affected by Huntington's disease back in Northern Ireland, and experienced it firsthand with my aunt and uncle who had it whenever I was a child. I have only memories of them being in wheelchairs. I started to notice the subtle signs in my dad whenever I was a teenager, and every year I've watched him deteriorate mentally and physically ever since.
I was naturally drawn to studying Huntington's, but what really fascinated me about the disease was that despite researchers knowing the exact cause of Huntington's disease since 1993, there still remains so much unknown about this extremely complex brain disease. Huntington's disease is a genetic, neurodegenerative, and ultimately fatal disease with devastating impact on individuals and entire families. Huntington's causes problems with a person's ability to think, behave, and move. Over time, the disease causes progressive functional decline, leading to a loss of independence and the ability to perform daily activities. Huntington's typically strikes a person in the prime of their life, between the ages of 30 and 50, although symptoms may appear earlier or later. Today, clinical diagnosis is made when movement problems are obvious. However, subtle changes known as prodromal or premotor onset symptoms often appear years earlier. Each child of a parent with Huntington's has a 50% chance of inheriting the disease, which affects men and women equally. We call this pattern of inheritance autosomal dominant. About 1 in 10,000 people live with Huntington's today, with many more at risk, including over 30 individuals within my own family. Everyone has two copies of the Huntington gene, which contains a section of repeated genetic letters known as CAG repeats. The Huntington protein is produced throughout the body, and although the normal function is not yet fully understood, it is thought to be involved in many biological functions, including the development of the nervous system. Huntington's disease occurs when one copy of the Huntington gene has a CAG repeat expansion over a certain threshold. People with 40 or more CAG repeats will develop Huntington's in their lifetime. People with 36 to 39 repeats may or may not develop the disease within an average lifespan. And those with 27 to 35 CAGs will not develop Huntington's themselves, but risk passing on the disease to the next generation. The Huntington gene carries instructions to make the Huntington protein. The DNA is used to create a messenger RNA that carries the code to the cellular factory that makes the protein. Too many CAG repeats result in a toxic form of the protein being produced, known as mutant Huntington protein. Mutant Huntington protein damages the normal functioning of neurons in many ways, including interfering with their transport networks and gene regulation. This causes them to malfunction and die prematurely, resulting in the symptoms of Huntington's. Huntington's is increasingly recognized as a disease of the whole brain and body. Areas of the brain responsible for cognition, personality, and movement are particularly affected, leading to the classic triad of symptoms in Huntington's disease. While research is ongoing, there is currently no treatment that can slow, stop, or reverse disease progression in Huntington's. The goals of current disease management focus on providing symptom relief, maximizing function, and optimizing quality of life. It's because of my family and Huntington's families around the world that I and other scientists continue to work to progress Huntington's disease research. It is a huge collaborative effort between researchers and family members, that will bring about a new chapter in this fight against Huntington's disease.